right, man. So we're here with Marcus Browne, man. How important is it for you to rep New York and get a fan base out here?
Very important. I mean, in anything that you do, if you don't gain momentum in your hometown and in your home city, then obviously you can't gain momentum anywhere else. You got to take over home first.
What do you think your advantages are in the light heavyweight division?
My speed, my intelligence, my power, my skill set. I mean, I feel like I'm a well-rounded fighter, but I don't want to talk. I'd rather show it.
How many more fights until you think you're fighting the elite level guys? Like, you know, possibly like Adonis Stevenson, Sergey, yeah. Kovalev kind of guy.
Me and Adonis can go to the next fight. It really don't matter to me. It's all up on them. You know what I'm saying? Me personally, I feel like I'm ready for an Adonis Stevenson for the next fight. And I'm just waiting for my shot. I'm just being patient though, you know?
How important was being Olympian to your experience as a boxer today?
How important was being an Olympian?
Yeah.
It was very important. You know, it showed me how I could go through anything, because I actually made the Olympic team twice. If you guys didn't know,
because
I won the Olympic trials, and then I lost my qualifying bout in the World Championship. So I had to win the U.S. Championships again to be able to go to Brazil to qualify, and I did that. So basically, I mean, that was important, and it showed me that, you know, I could stick it in, I could grind it out when the cards are stacked against me, and I did it.
Okay.
Are you a natural southpaw, or?
Yeah, I'm a natural southpaw.
Natural?
Yeah.
All right. So your power is actually in your left hand?
Yeah.
So, okay, all right. And I was talking to Demetrius Andre, and he said that he would like to bring you in as a sparring partner.
Demetrius Andre?
Yeah.
I'm not a sparring partner though.
I know. But you know, you guys are different weight classes.
Yeah. But me and Boo Boo, I mean, we like family though. Me and Boo Boo like family.
Because we were watching your last fight at the Barclays, me and him both together.
Okay.
And he was talking about, he was like, now that man I would like to bring into the camp so he could get ready. Yeah.
You serious?
Yeah.
Yeah, what you call it? But that's so funny. Yo, Boo Boo, holla at me, and I need that, man. You know what I'm saying? Because he wanted the slickest southpaws out there.
Yeah, exactly. That's something
so
you can learn from, right?
So me personally, I could learn from a great fighter like that. And he was a 2008 Olympian. So at the end of the day, you know, we're both Olympians, and we could both teach each other some things. I mean,
that'd,
you know what I'm saying?
Good.
And that'll be some great work.
That sparring right there.
That'll be some great work. You know, Uncle Dre, you know, my Uncle Dre, you know, works with him a little bit. So, you know, we like family.
Might not be able to spar too much, man.
Of course not, you know.
Wars in there.
Of course, you know how that goes, man.
So, how has being a father changed your life?
I'm not living just for me. I'm not living to just buy J's all day and get fly. You know what I'm saying? These ain't the low tops, please. If you got them low tops, throw them in the garbage, man. These are better, please. But, you know, it's not, the focus is just not on me anymore. And, you know, it just put everything into perspective, you know, that there's more important things in life, you know what I'm saying? And right now is my baby girl.
Right now, you're right at that point in your career where you could project to the elite level and be right there. So now having a baby, does that get you more motivated?
Of course, you know how that go, but... I mean, at the end of the day, I feel like I motivate myself, you know what I'm saying? I get up, I grind. I've been doing this since I was 13, now I'm 24, so I mean, it's every day.
What are the differences now having your baby, and are you still in training camp right now? Or has it just finished and wrapped up?
I mean, we basically wrapping up, but I'm about to go to the gym soon as I leave you guys, and I don't know, I'm ready.
Has it changed at all? I mean, has the regimen changed? Now you're, you know, like, having to wake up in the middle of the night and stuff,
that's crazy, but not necessarily, because my girl, she's a good woman, and she's been, you know, doing her job, and I've been helping her, you know. So
how have you felt the fan support from New York? Do you feel like now when you're walking through the streets, since you've been on PBC and been on major networks, that people are starting to recognize you?
I mean, yeah, of course, but that's not what I really care about. I don't care about being recognized. I care about being recognized in a sanctioning body and having a strap around my waist. That's what I really care about.
So how soon until we see you be a champion?
Whenever they give me my shot. Whenever they give my shot, Donna Stevenson, Kovalev, holler at me. Whenever they give me my shot. Whenever they give me my shot.
There you go.